Assuming that, hypothetically, immortality was possible, would you even want to live forever? If everyone lived forever, what would the population of the world be? With no one dying of natural causes, we'd probably have more wars, as there would be more pressure on food and water sources. What would relationships be like? Would you be able to live with a partner forever? How many children would you have? How would inheritance work with multiple generations being alive at the same time? Perhaps human beings aren't meant to be immortal in this life, but achieving a longer lifespan is something definitely within our grasp. Advancements in medical science over the last 200 years have resulted in a drastic increase in the average human lifespan. In the 1800s, the average age of a normal adult was around 60, whereas today the average age of a normal adult is roughly between the 70s and 80s mark. So we can see that improvements in medical science over the years have managed to increase our average lifespan. But what scientists are achieving with their increased understanding of aging is going to extend the average lifespan up to almost over 100 years easily for the coming generations. In fact, scientists are sure that the children of today will live up to over 100 years. So the question is, what is aging? Aging is simply the process of deterioration of our cells throughout our life. For most of our life, our body simply regenerates the cells that die, and in this manner, our body keeps on functioning normally. But as we get older, our body slows down the process of regenerating the broken down cells. This slowdown in the pace of regeneration results in various diseases and reduction in the function of our organs, which eventually results in our death. We start aging right after we're born. The cells in our body die and are replaced by new cells roughly every 7 to 8 years. Every cell in our body gets replaced. Stem cells play a major part in this cell replacement. But as we age, the rate of cell reproduction and replacement slows down. And by the time we reach 50 or 60 years of age, depending on our lifestyle, the cell reproduction becomes so slow that the body starts to deteriorate at a rate faster than it's able to make new cells. This results in life-threatening diseases. So if you could fundamentally reverse the aging process, the diseases that result in death would simply go away, and our organs would remain healthy, which would allow us to not only have an increased lifespan, but also a higher and better quality of life into our old age. Death, in this case, would neither be slow nor painful. At present, there are more people above the age of 65 in the world than there are children under the age of 5. Many countries, such as Japan, have an increasing number of elderly. China's just raised the limit of children a family could have from 2 to 3 because their forecasts predict a growing elderly population. The last 5 to 7 years for most people who make it to an old age are the most painful of all because of diseases and dependability on others. This is why scientists are not only looking to increase the average lifespan, but also increase the quality of life so that we can lead a longer and more functional life. In order to increase the quality of life, scientists needed to crack the riddle of aging. Slowing down aging will give us a longer lifespan, but it would not reduce the problems that come with age. It would simply delay those problems. Whereas reversing the aging process would not only increase the lifespan, but also improve the quality of life in later years by reducing the likelihood of life-threatening diseases. The answer to reversing the aging process lies in our understanding of the main causes of aging, which have been identified by scientists as genomic instability, epigenetic alteration, telomere attrition, stem cell exhaustion, and cellular senescence. By understanding these hallmarks, scientists have been able to come up with ways of reversing the process of aging. These 5 hallmarks are not different processes within our body, they're all interlinked and work as a chain reaction. Controlling any one of them can result in reduction in the pace of aging. Remember what we said earlier, the process of aging starts right from our birth and results in our death. For the greater part of our lives, these cells in our body break down and regenerate without any problems. But as we age, the pace of this regeneration slows down, which ends up creating problems. This slowdown in the pace of cell regeneration is known as genomic instability. Consider cell replication similar to getting a photocopy. The first copy you get from the original document is the clearest. But as you continue to make copies, the ink in the printer starts to run out, and each subsequent printout becomes lighter until there's nothing being printed on the page at all. This is how, over the span of our life, our genome breaks down. Now, the reason why our genome breaks down is because there's a little thing called telomere, which is part of our DNA. Think of it like this. If our chromosomes are like shoelaces, then the telomere is the plastic tip on the end of the shoelace. A telomere protects the chromosome during cell replication. The problem with telomeres is that every time our cells replicate, the length of the telomere reduces. By the time we're 50 or 60 years of age, the telomeres have degraded so much that they simply can't replicate anymore. When this happens, our cell replication stops, which results in stem cell exhaustion. This is basically an accumulation of old dead cells in the body. Now, once scientists understood this, they realized that they could try to tackle the problem of aging. This is what Dr. David Sinclair and his team of researchers at Harvard did by targeting the epigenome. But what's an epigenome, you might ask? Well, an epigenome is like the control system of the genome. The reason why parts of the body go wrong is the reason the epigenome becomes unregulated. For most of our lives, these cells in our body keep a fixed identity. The nerve cells function as nerve cells. The optic cells function as optic cells, etc. But as we grow older, the genomic function in our cells begins to break down, and so these cells lose their sense of identity. Dr. David Sinclair claims to have carried out successful tests on mice where he and his team used gene therapy to reverse the aging. In an experiment, Dr. Sinclair and his team of researchers activated three genes in mice that are only activated in very young mice. This test was focused on regenerating the molecules in the eyes of old mice. What Dr. Sinclair found was that by turning on those three genes, the age of the selected molecules in the eyes of the mice had reversed. The experiment, according to Dr. David Sinclair, was successful, and his team has established a basic principle that aging can be reversed. The mice were able to live up to 40% longer as a result of this experiment. In a similar experiment, a team of researchers at Stanford extracted aged molecules, activated the young genes, and reinserted them into mice. This experiment also yielded a similar result. All that remains to be done now is to scale up these experiments and apply them to humans. Yes, it may take a few years, maybe a couple of decades, but there's a very viable solution that scientists can work towards. Meanwhile, researchers at Tel Aviv University have successfully reversed aging by using oxygen therapy. Dr. Shai Efrati at the Shamir Medical Center in Tel Aviv says that there's a switch within our bodies that can stimulate the production of stem cells, which can increase the rate of cell reproduction to not only reduce but even reverse the process of aging. But this switch can only be activated when we face hypoxia, or in other words, a shortage of oxygen. Now, under normal conditions, hypoxia can be achieved by slowing down the breathing and reducing the heart rate. But the catch is that inducing hypoxia is dangerous for the body. The lack of oxygen can quickly damage the muscles and tissue in the heart and brain, resulting in irreversible damage. Dr. Shai and his team realized that there's another way of inducing hypoxia without damaging the body, and this can be done through oxygen therapy. The subjects simply have to be put in a hyperbaric or high-pressure chamber with pure oxygen. The high pressure of oxygen expands the lungs and results in an increase in the oxygen concentration in the blood. As the oxygen concentration increases, the body becomes used to extremely high levels of oxygen. The pressure in the chamber is then reduced to normal, and this drops the extremely high concentration of oxygen in the blood abruptly down to normal levels. This sudden fluctuation of the body's oxygen level triggers the body to think that it's in hypoxia, and the body starts producing stem cells at a faster rate. This is basically a simple hack to force the body to heal itself. Studies have shown that oxygen therapy can repair DNA and increase the length of the telomeres by almost 20%, which means that oxygen therapy can effectively reverse aging. Gene therapy is still in its early stages, and oxygen therapy is not something that most people will be able to afford to do. So is there any way to reverse aging that we have access to right now, or is this simply out of our reach? Well, according to Dr. David Sinclair, there is a very simple way to reverse aging. It's something that we've all always known, but now research is proving just how useful it is. Autophagy is the process of going hungry when our body indicates that it needs food. Or, in simpler terms, fasting a few times each month is the simplest way to trigger a healing response from the body. When we deny food to our body, it triggers a reaction where the body starts to cleanse itself of dead and old proteins. It also heals the genome and restores the telomeres. When you combine fasting with a healthy lifestyle, healthy food and exercise, you supercharge your body to reverse the aging process and remain in top form. So while pills to reverse aging may be a thing of the future, we can at least try to reduce our aging process by adopting a healthier lifestyle and fasting intermittently each month. What do you think of these studies? Do you think humans will be able to live for hundreds of years? And would you even want to live that long? Let us know your thoughts in the comments section down below. If you enjoyed this video and you want to see more, make sure you hit that subscribe button to stay updated on all our latest releases. Other than that, thanks for tuning in, and I'll see you in the next video.